Hello, it's nice having you again on my channel. Yeah, today we'll be having to do with trigonometry again, but yeah, we're doing with the trigonometry involving trigonometry of acute angles. So if you have acute angles, that is angles that are less than 90, those angles fall between 0 and 90. So when you have angles that deal with them, and those angles enclose sides, and you're looking for that, either the angle or the sides, what do you do? So there are some trig identities that you need to know around them. Yes, there are some trig ratios that you're supposed to identify. Look at this, for example. You have theta here, you have y here, you have this whole place to be x, and this hypotenuse to be y. Of course, this is like a right angle triangle here. There's a right angle here, of course, because this is forming a perpendicular line. It's perpendicular to this horizontal line with x. So now I want to write for each of the trig identities. So if you have sine theta here, sine theta can be equal to what? This is opposite over so. So from Socrates, what we did in the previous video, so opposite over hypotenuse. This opposite. This is y over the hypotenuse is z. Do you get that? Now if we have cos theta, let's treat cos theta. Cos theta, which is car, adjacent over hypotenuse. This is the opposite, is hypotenuse. Where is the adjacent? The adjacent is the x. So you have x. You need to have x adjacent over hypotenuse, x over z. X over z. So let's look at tan theta is always sine theta over cos theta. And so that is equal to what is sine theta? Y over z. Over means divided upon cos theta. That is divided by x over z, and that shall be equal to y over z times z over x. Z cancel out z, so tan theta eventually becomes what? Y upon x. You get it? Now, if you're looking for cos theta, there's something called cot theta. Cot theta is always 1 over tan theta. And that is the same thing as, since tan theta is sine theta over cos theta will be cos theta, I mean cot theta, will be cos theta over sine theta. So we have cos theta over sine theta. And since cos theta is the one giving us cos theta over sine theta, and that is 1 over tan theta. Our tan theta is 1 over y upon x. So the inverse of y upon x is x upon y. If you do it the way we did this tan theta, write it out, that is cos theta divided by sine theta, you break it down, you turn to multiplication, do that, you are going to get y upon x. Do you get that? Let me use this to write this. X upon y, rather. Do you get that? We have other identities. Let me quickly make mention of this. We have we still have, let me make mention of sec theta is always 1 upon cos theta, and that should be equals. What is 1 upon cos theta? What is cos theta? Cos theta is x over z, so that is 1 upon x upon z, and that is just 1 over 1 divided by x upon z, and that is equals to 1 upon 1 times the division changes to multiplication times z upon x. So your final answer, sec theta is z upon x. It's z upon x. So that's that. Then I can equally give you another one, which is for this. Let me just wipe this side. Just take it for me like that. We have cosec theta. Cosec theta is 1 upon sine theta. And that can be equal to what? 1 upon sine theta. Sine theta, of course, is y over z. So 1 divided by y upon z. That will definitely, just like we did here, finish your workings, you'll say you're going to be having y upon z. So that means if you are looking for cosec theta, you look after this, you check cosec theta will be 1 upon sine theta, and that will be what? Sine theta, you know, of course, sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse. Y over z, then the inverse of this will be z over y. Yeah, sorry, there was a mistake here. By z upon y. Let's quickly treat an example before I lock up this video. We have this. We have this question. So the question says, We have a right angle triangle with two given sides and a known angle. We have to look for, okay, let me just write it out. You have this triangle, you have this. Even as 5. You have this as 5, you have this as 4. You have this place as alpha. You have this place as A. We are told find alpha, 2, find A. Okay, let me make a reverse of that. Find A, then find alpha. So you find A, find alpha. This is a right angle triangle. It was written there. So we are looking for a third side. Given as a right angle triangle, of course we should know. The right angle triangle, if you're looking for any side of it, you apply what we call the Pythagoras theorem. The Pythagoras theorem, I've mentioned that in a previous video. Thank you, I know you should know that. So you should have the Pythagoras theorem states. Have 5 squared to be equal to, okay, let me mention this, that the hypotenuse squared is equal to what? The either opposite squared plus adjacent squared. That is, the longest side, which is the hypotenuse, the square of it will be equal to the square summation of the squared or squared of the two other two sides squared. So summation of the square of the other two sides. Do you understand? So we have the, that means this is 5 squared can be equal to 4 squared plus a squared. Of course, since you are looking for a, make so collect like terms so that we're going to be having 5 squared minus 4 squared can be equal to a squared. Then this is 25 minus 16, that should be 9, can be equal to a squared. So a can be equal to the square root of 9. So what do we have there? Let me finish that here. So since you're having the square root, please indicate to be plus or minus. So once you find the square root of any value, whatever your answer becomes, you're going to your a become plus or minus 3. That's what it will give you. But because it's the side, it won't be negative. It will definitely be just 3. That is plus 3. Because it's a length of a side, so it can't be negative. But because you find the square root of a value, it's as carrying length plus or minus. Please take note of that. Now, we have gotten our a, right? Let's go find alpha. Looking out for alpha. How do we go about this? Now we go to our soul quatuor that we mentioned in the previous video. The knowledge of that is what will help us out to find this, because one, this triangle is a right angle triangle, and we have two sides given already. We don't have to deal with the third side. We just need two sides. Then we are good. We are good to go. So we have two sides here. We have the hypotenuse. We have the opposite. So we are using soul. You can show sine alpha can be equal to the opposite, which is 4, upon the hypotenuse, which is 5. Do you get that? So sine alpha, what is 4 upon 5? 4 divided by 5. Okay, let's just do it here. 5 and 4, that is 0. Point. 4, 5 can divide 4, right? 0 point, you add 0 here. 5 and 40, that is 8. So since you are looking for alpha, it says alpha can be equal to the sine inverse of 0.8. So alpha can be equal to what? Sine inverse of 0.8, punch your calculator, that will be shift sine, shift sine of 0.8. And that is 53.13, yeah, 53.13 degrees, because it's an angle. So we are good and we are done. So let me quickly give you a question you can play with. Let me give you something to play with. Okay, let me just clean this. You are looking for something similar. Let me just clear this, clear this, clear this. So let me give this as B. Solve this out. This is B. This is let me give you this as so we have this. Yes, we have this as an unknown. Let's give you 6 here. Let me give you 8 here. Okay, I will give you 10 there. You 10 meters, 6 meters. So you are looking for both alpha and b. Just solve that as an exercise. If you can go through that, make a comment in the comment box. I will reply with an explanation to you. Thank you. Please kindly subscribe, like my videos, of course, punch that button, like it. Yeah. Thank you very much. Goodbye.